For an instant, it looked as though it had checked the vehicle. Then the truck expelled an extra puff of bluish-grey smoke from the exhaust pipe, roared like some prehistoric creature, and smashed the solid boom into smithereens. A cloud of dust rose from the gravel behind as it raced on, up Gollibacken Hill and into Istalen, 50 meters up the slope above Svartediket, the main reservoir for the town's drinking water. Chapter 51. Istalen divides the Flöjen and Ulriken mountains like a Canadian valley, surrounded by spruce trees, with the huge lake of Svartediket in the middle. Originally, it was only the furthermost valley floor up towards Kieften and Trolldalen at the back of Ulriken that was called Istalen, but the name had come to embrace the whole of the valley that used to be called Vorkendalen. Vorkendalen had been reduced to the sheer ascent to Talebø in the north, while Hardbakkedalen climbed steeply in the northeast and led to Borgarskaret, which had been the traffic artery and postal route since as far back as King Sverre in the late 12th century. Until the early 1950s, the furthest farms were occupied. Now the valley was deserted, apart from the constant criss-crossing of runners and hikers, dog owners and tourists. The valley had kept the appearance of a wilderness. Standing on the furthest bank of Svartediket, it was hard to imagine that you were within walking distance of Norway's second biggest city. The green vacuum tank tore through this valley like a lobotomized bull in a china shop. Bård Farang kept his hand pressed down on the horn so that walkers and runners could jump aside and not end up as flat as worn trainers.